Okay, good afternoon students. Today we are going to study with the next topic, that is connective tissue. So before this we have completed epithelial tissue, five different types of epithelial tissue, correct? Squamous epithelium, cuboidal epithelium, columnar epithelium, ciliated epithelium and glandular epithelium. Now today we are going to start with the next type of a tissue, that is connective tissue. As the word suggests, connection. So this is a type of a tissue which connects and supports the different other tissues of the body. We all know that we are generally made up of cell and we are multicellular organism. So as we are multicellular organism, cell will divide and it will form a group of cell. That group of cell is called tissue. So there are different kinds of the tissues present in the body, and this connective tissue is one of them which connects all the other tissues of the body. Okay, now near about 30% of the body is generally formed by connective tissue. Now this connective tissue is mesodermal in origin. It contains its own blood vessel, right? They are having its own blood vessel. It is mesodermal in origin, and this type of a connective tissue contains large amount of matrix. You can see a large amount of cytoplasm is scattered all over the cell, right? So here the matrix or the cytoplasm is present in a large number. Okay, now connective tissue is divided into two important types. First one is called binding type and second is called supportating type. Okay, what do you mean by binding type? Binding type of a tissue is a tissue which will hold or bind the other parts or the organs of the body, correct? And next one is supportating tissue. Supportating tissue is a type of a tissue which is going to support the entire skeletal system of the body. So here binding tissue is of two type. First one is called areolar connective tissue and second one is called adipose connective tissue. Okay, and second supportating type is divided into two parts. One is called cartilage and second is called bone. So today we are going to study only about the binding type of tissue. The first one is areolar connective tissue. Again, we are going to study three major points. First, location, second, structure, and last, function. Okay, let's start with the very first one, areolar connective tissue. Can you see the word areola? Areola is nothing but air cavities. So it has been believed that this kind of a tissue contains some or the other air cavities, or you can say air pockets. That's why this tissue is called areolar connective tissue. This is the most widely distributed type of a connective tissue. Among connective tissue, the most widely distributed type of a tissue present in the human body is areolar connective tissue, and it is so called as true connective tissue. Now let's talk about the location of areolar connective tissue. This tissue is present beneath or below the skin. You know, our entire body is covered by the skin, right? Okay, the uppermost layer is called epidermis. Below the skin, you can see the first layer, that is called first layer epidermis. So below the epidermis, you can see the first, which is called skin, right? So it is present below the skin and in between the bone and muscles, right? In between the bone, in between the muscles also, areolar connective tissue is been located. Now let's come on to the structure. The structure of areolar connective tissue is made up of following important parts, two important parts. One is called as the cell and second is called as the fiber. So let's talk first about the cell. There are three different types of the cell. First is called fibroblast cell, second is called macrophages, and third is called mast cell. Right? Now let's talk about fibroblast cell. Fibroblast cells are star shaped or spindle shaped cell. Right? They are numerous in number, they are flat, they are spindle shaped, star shaped cell, which are called as fibroblast cell. And this fibroblast cell are responsible for the formation of the fiber, basically the white fiber or the collagen fiber. Okay, so fibroblast cells are star shaped, they are flat, they are numerous in number, and they are spindle shaped cell responsible for the formation of the collagen fiber or the white fibers. Right? Second one is called macrophages, right? Now you can see macrophages are amoeboid shaped cell, right? Amoeboid shaped cell, they are irregular in shape and they are basically phagocytic cell, right? Now let me talk about phagocytic cell. You know all, phagocytic cells are the cells which engulf or digest the other cell in the solid form. They are generally called macrophages or the phagocytic cell. Okay, so macrophages are irregular amoeboid shaped cell and the major function is they are phagocytic cell. They help in engulfing the other cell in the solid form. Come on, the third one, can you see this oval shaped cell? Yes, this oval shaped cell is called as the master cell, and the another name for the master cell is histiocyte cell. Okay, now this master cell or the histiocyte cell are responsible for the secretion of heparin, histamine and serotonin. Very important, right? Master cell is responsible for the secretion of heparin, histamine and serotonin. Come on, everyone knows what is heparin. Heparin is a type of a powerful anticoagulant, right? What is anticoagulant? Anticoagulant means which generally prevents the coagulation of the blood, right? So that is nothing but the first one called heparin, right? Second is histamine and serotonin. Okay, second is histamine and serotonin. These are also a specialized type of a secretion from the mast cell responsible for the constriction of the blood vessels, right? So for the constriction of the blood vessels, you require serotonin, histamine and heparin is a powerful anticoagulant. These are the three different types of the cells which are present in the areolar connective tissue. Okay, now let's talk about the fibers. There are two types of fiber. First one is called white fiber and second is called yellow fiber. Can you see white fiber? Yes, white fiber is like a wave, right? So white fibers are wavy and they are unbranched. They do not contain any kind of branching and they appear as a wave, right? Now this white fibers are made up of a protein called collagen protein. Right, this white fibers are made up of a protein called collagen protein, that's why they are also called as collagen fiber. And this white fibers or collagen fiber are responsible for the formation of the tendon. Right, now what exactly is tendon? Bone to muscle joint is called as tendon. You can see here is a bone and we have a muscles covering with it. So a connection between the bone and a muscle is called tendon, which is generally formed by the collagen fiber, so called as white fiber. Clear? See the second one, that is yellow fiber. Can you see yellow fiber? It is straight. Correct? It is straight or linear and it is having many branches. Can you see? It is having many branches. So this your yellow fiber is straight, linear and it is branched structure. Similarly, yellow fiber is also made up of a protein called elastin. That's why such kind of a fiber are called elastin fibers. Okay. And this yellow fibers are responsible for the formation of ligament. Now what is ligament? Ligament is bone to bone joint. Okay, so if there is a joint between bone to bone, then that is called ligament. And if there is a joint between bone to muscle, it is called tendon. Okay, so that's what all about your yellow fiber and white fiber. Yellow fiber are called elastin fiber. Why? Because they are made up of elastin protein. And white fibers are called collagen fiber because they are generally made up of collagen protein. The entire cell is scattered or surrounded by a homogeneous mixture. That homogeneous mixture is called matrix or the cytoplasm. Okay, last function. What is the function of areolar connective tissue? This is the type of a tissue which connects all the other parts of the body and it acts as a packaging tissue. Okay, so the name which is given to this areolar tissue is, it is a packaging type of a tissue. Okay, next one, second one is adipose tissue, right? The second one is called adipose tissue. Now adipose tissue is a fat storing tissue. Okay, the basic function of this tissue is that it is going to store the fat. Now, adipose tissue is a modified areolar connective tissue. What do you mean by this statement? This is your adipose tissue, this is your areolar tissue. So, this adipose tissue is a part of a modified areolar connective tissue. Let's talk about the location. adipose tissue is also present below the skin. Yes, it is present around the heart, around the kidney, around the eye socket, etc. Okay, so this type of a tissue is present around the heart, around the kidney, skin, and also eye socket. Now let's talk about adipose tissue in detail. Adipose tissue contains a fat storing cell. That fat storing cell is called adipocyte cell. Right? Okay. So adipose tissue contains a fat storing cell. That fat storing cell is called adipocyte cell. Now what happens in the early stage, each fat is present as a fat droplet. Okay, in the early stage, every fat is present as a fat droplet. Now what happens in the later stage is that every fat droplet will unite with each other. Every fat droplet will unite with each other, fuse with each other to form a larger fat globule. Okay, so these are the smaller fat droplet. They will unite with each other, they will fuse with each other and will form a larger cell that is called as fat globule. Now what happens is that the entire cell stores a large amount of fat, right? So there is the accumulation of or deposition of too much of fat in the fat storing cell so that the nucleus from the center is shifted to the periphery. Is the nucleus present at the center? No, it is present at the periphery, correct? Okay, so due to the deposition of the fat in the fat storing cell, the nucleus is shifted to the periphery. This is called eccentric nucleus. This is called eccentric nucleus. So eccentric nucleus means the nucleus is shifted at the periphery due to the deposition of the fat. Now, you can also say that the entire adipose tissue also contains what? It also contains your homogeneous mixture, and that homogeneous mixture is called matrix. Matrix or the cytoplasm. Now here, there are two types of adipose tissue, that is brown adipose tissue. Okay, brown or red adipose tissue, and one is called yellow adipose tissue. Yellow adipose tissue will be responsible for the storing of fat, whereas the brown adipose tissue is responsible for the storage of blood cell, right? As it stores the blood cell, it is red in appear. So it is called brown adipose tissue, and yellow adipose tissue majorly stores the fat. Take a simple example. Have you ever seen camel's hump? Yes, right? Camel's hump is also made up of adipose tissue as it stores a large amount of the fat. Okay, now the last point, that is the function of adipose tissue. Adipose tissue is a fat storing tissue and it generally acts as a shock absorber. Mechanical shock absorber tissue is adipose tissue and it also acts as a insulation to the body. Okay, so here we complete with the entire binding type of tissue. The first one is called areolar connective tissue. Second is called adipose connective tissue. Here it is made up of two part, fibers and the cell. Three types of cell, fibroblast cell, macrophages, mast cell. Two types of fiber, that is white fiber or collagen fiber, and second is yellow fiber or elastin fiber. And about adipose tissue, fat storing cell are called adipocyte cells, right? And fat is present in the form of fat droplets. This fat droplet will fuse to form the larger fat globule. Thank you.